I've always worked in mathematical biology during my PhD, but I was working on plant sciences and I was quite keen to move into human biology in some capacity. And obviously a postdoc at a pharmaceutical firm offered me that, as well as some additional experience that couldn't necessarily be offered in academia. I feel like here at AstraZeneca, I can really see the impact my work is going to have.
So I worked before at AstraZeneca as an intern for 6 months, and I was really excited about what we are doing at AstraZeneca with AI tools to really help patients.
So AstraZeneca has access to excellent computational infrastructure and other resources that I need for my work. In addition to that, AstraZeneca also has support teams that help you across various aspects of your project.
We are generating vast amounts of data across all of our projects. And what we have, which maybe many other organisations don't have, is these huge data sets that we can begin to use to probe, to try and understand what those data sets mean, how they can help us deliver drug discovery projects faster. A postdoc coming into AstraZeneca has access to those data sources. They have access to best in the world infrastructure that we can then use to probe those data sources.
Nowadays in chemistry, everything tends to go towards high throughput chemistry, which means that more and more chemical reactions are carried out in a short amount of time, which means we are collecting way more data, and this data needs to be analyzed and cannot be analyzed by humans anymore. And so having an artificial intelligence which can do some of the work obviously gives a lot of benefits and saves a lot of time overall.
So some of the data sets that they have access to are very unique, very rich, very large, and they're not really available anywhere else. But beyond that, the postdoc program offers postdocs all kinds of additional opportunities, such as communications training or networking opportunities, opportunities to learn about the wider drug discovery and development program that allows them to build up their portfolio of skills in such a way that will serve them well, no matter what career path they choose in the future.
So at AstraZeneca, it's not only the research part, which I am doing, but also we have a lot of different data science communities. From this year, I started to lead one of them, next-gen data scientist, and we are organizing different seminars to get to know better what people at different departments are doing with AI.
We have experts in all different kinds of fields, which allows everybody who is working within this area to reach out to people that are experts in this specific niche that might help you for your own research. And it's always just one message away to just ask someone, okay, do you want to meet with me? I'm interested in your research. Can we speak about it?
Here at AstraZeneca, you get to sit within a broader team that's part of a much larger organization. And that exposure can be really insightful, particularly if you're torn between an academic research position or moving into industry.
I am working with some senior data scientists. They are helping me with development of my models and also with cardiologists. It is very important for my research because we are trying to solve real problems, not just to advance the model to beat some statistics. The best thing is that I had this connection with different specialists and that I am free in my research as well. I can say what I would like to do next, and I can understand what kind of impact this will make.
I'm surrounded by many individuals who have years and years of experience, and therefore they are very able to guide me in the work that I do. And third, and not least obviously, is the connection with the academia, quite literally across the street from us.
Today, we have the ability to sequence hundreds of thousands of human genomes to generate data that tells us which genes are associated with which disease to help us choose the projects that we should take forward. And a lot of the work that we've done in that area, again around creating the underpinning technologies that allow us to do it, has been supported by scientists within the postdoc programme.